Now, moving on. Wide receivers. Top 10 wide receivers now. At number 10, if you have a Bucs wide receiver, start. The issue here is they've got so many. I'm not counting Gronkowski. Gronkowski covers the tight end position. You don't know who's going to get the ball. They've got three guys over there. Godwin had 14 targets last week. Brown had 7 targets. They both went over 100 yards. Both had a touchdown. And Mike Evans was kind of on the outs. This week, it's probably going to be the same 2 out of 3. It could be 3 out of 3. Who knows? But if you have one, you got to start him. Take your shot. I've got a lot of Bucs wide receivers, actually. I think I've got all 3 of them in all 4 of my leagues at some point. At one point. So, go. If you got a Bucs wide receiver, go with them. And just go like this. And hope for a big game. Because you know Brady's going to have a big game. Because the land stinks. You saw what Jalen Hurts did. So that's number 10. Any Bucs receiver. Number 9, Davante Adams. Now, I had him at number 1 last week. That didn't work out. He's still the top target over there. I think they're going to play a little more of a normal game this week. You've got Monday night. You got the lights on. You got Detroit coming in. You can't lose this game. If you do, you got huge problems. So we're going to go Davante Adams playing well. He's my number 9. Number 8, Calvin Ridley, because I think they're going to be down so much, you're going to have to throw the ball. I think he gets a touchdown. Hopefully he gets 100 yards, but I think he gets upwards of 10 targets. So we go with Calvin Ridley making up for last week's game this week against Tampa Bay. And don't forget, Dak Prescott threw the ball all over the place against Tampa Bay. Now, Matt Ryan is not Dak Prescott, and Brady did troll him a little bit this week with the 28-3 on the clock or whatever that was. Number 7, Keenan Allen against Dallas. Everything goes back to that last Thursday night game. You saw what Brady did to Dallas. Why can't Justin Herbert do that to Dallas as well? Dallas doesn't have the greatest defense. Now, the Chargers do not have the greatest offensive line to defend against, the rookie they got out there. I forget what that guy's name is, but that guy looked good. But they are missing DeMarcus Lawrence. I think he got hurt, so that could be a problem. Number 6, Stephon Diggs against Miami. I think they play well. I think he comes back. He only caught like 6 for 45 last week. I think he has a better game this week, so I put him at number 6. Number 5, DeAndre Hopkins against Minnesota. He could blow up this week. As you saw last week with Joe Burrow against Minnesota, we could see the same thing with Josh Allen. With Kyler Murray against Minnesota, same thing maybe. So we'll see what happens there. Number 4, T. Higgins. I like T. Higgins. I've been telling you I like T. Higgins. I think he blows up this week against Chicago because who do they have to cover that big 6'4 frame? Number 3, DJ Moore against New Orleans. Like I said, I like Carolina. I got to think for DJ Moore this week. I think he goes for over 100 yards and a touchdown. Number 2, DK Metcalf. Again, try and cover that big guy with those little quarterbacks. We're going to go with DK Metcalf, catch one of those moonshots. And number 1, I like Tyreek Hill to just decimate Baltimore's secondary. You got no Marcus Peters back there. You do have other guys back there. But like I said, I'm going against the snake bit team. Don't like the snake bites. So that's my top 10 wide receivers. So good luck.